Welcome to video number 6 of our APRV video series, and in today's video we're gonna cover COVID-19 patients, how to use APRV in COVID-19 patients that having hypoxic respiratory failure. Please remember to watch this video series in order, as every video builds on the video before. And remember to subscribe to our channel if you have not done so, and share it with your colleagues if you find it useful. And let's start after this short intro. Using TCAV, which is again a specific method of APRV as an inverse ratio ventilation in COVID-19 patient, is similar to what we explained in our last videos. A lot of information here was mentioned before, but let's say you have a COVID-19 patient who's having worsening pneumonia. He's on 100% FiO2 using, let's say, high flow nasal cannula or CPAP, and he's still getting hypoxic, and you decided to intubate this patient. It's okay. Let's say you intubate this patient. It's okay. Again, you can put them directly out on TCAV as an initial mode of ventilation. And I really encourage this. You don't have to use the conventional mode of ventilation and then fail them in order to use this method. If you're comfortable with the TCAV, hopefully you'll be comfortable by watching these videos, go ahead and use it right away. You don't have to fail the other one and then transition from. If the patient was already, let's say, on pressure control mode of ventilation or volume control mode of ventilation, and he's still having refractory hypoxemia, then you can transition them as a rescue mode. Okay, remember that in all patients, regardless whether they are COVID-19, any patient who becomes intubated and undergoing positive pressure ventilation, they are at risk of hypotension if they are preload dependent. Because remember, positive pressure ventilation decrease preload and decrease venous return, right? So these volume depleted patients, make sure you resuscitate them. Let's say you intubated somebody and he became profoundly hypotensive. Don't rush to vasopressors. Give them a liter or two of LR or NS before considering putting them on vasopressors. As I said, the only contraindication to that, if they are frankly having pulmonary edema and signs of fluid overload, and they are clearly not preload dependent. So that's the first step here. The second step, the initial values you're gonna use when you put a COVID-19 patients on TCAV. Again, I prefer you go to the videos that we mentioned, but if you do not want to, roughly these values I'm going to mention now, they will be good as long as you will be monitoring these patients. Okay, P high, put them 30 centimeter H2O, unless the patient is morbidly obese. If the patient is morbidly obese, you can go to 35. P low, as we said, 0. T high, 5 seconds, we would be good. T low, 0.5 second. If out, of course, these patients are hypoxic, we're going to use 100% at the beginning. Respiratory rate, it's already decided. How? 5 and 0.5, so 60 divided by 5.5, roughly will be what? 11, 12, let's say 12. So this is already decided by these values, remember that. And pressure support, as I said, these patients, if they are not paralyzed, because the other pitfall, we jump to paralyze these patients. We don't have to. They usually can be lightly sedated. They can be awake, taking spontaneous breaths, and they will be comfortable. The only time I paralyze them is when I need to have full control on their respiratory mechanics and they are fighting the vent. So for this spontaneous breath, I don't recommend to give any pressure support, but the only, if we decide to give pressure support for these extra breaths that's not supported with these values here, I suggest use something called ATC, automatic tube compensation. Basically, there is a software in the ventilator where you put the size of the ET tube and the ventilator will automatically by itself measure the resistance there and give pressure that's adequate to overcome the ET tube resistance. So these values would be good, and then you need to monitor the patients. Monitor, of course, their tidal volume to see if the patient adequately ventilated, tidal volume and minute ventilation, and monitor their O2 sat, and also do an ABG within 1 to 2 hours to see if the ventilation is stable. Because I do not recommend to touch the T high and T low until we see what's the tidal volume, because our goal is to be 6 or let's say 6 to 8 mil per kg. If you decide to, for P-high, to use the peak pressure on pressure control or plateau pressure, when we transition, as we explained before, that's okay. But these roughly values should be okay, as we mentioned. But let's go back now. After you put the patient on these settings, I want you to pay attention to their tidal volume. Is it falling 6 to 8 mL/kg? We good. Autosat improving. We good. ABG. The CO2 is okay. The pH is not terrible. Then at that point, you may start going up on the T high by 1 second every couple of hours, because our really goal eventually, if it's possible, to come to 9 seconds here and leave this as it is, if possible, because this will cause more recruitment and improving in oxygenation. If the tidal volume is low, of course, as we explained on how to adjust tidal volume, you need to come down. As I said, simply you can go say, okay, let me increase T low, but we want you to come down on T high by increasing respiratory rate, or by directly setting T high to, let's say, from 5, you can go to 4 seconds, for example. By default, that means now the T low occupying more in the respiratory cycle. So it's not an absolute increase in the number or duration of T-low, but the T-low now representing a higher percentage of the respiratory cycle. If you cannot think and really you need to do something quick, you may play with the release time. Of course, if you want to improve the tidal volume too small, you can increase the T-low to, let's say, 0.8 seconds. And I forgot to mention that with COPD patient, if you decide to put somebody with COPD on APRV, TCAV, make sure the T-low here, the starting value in COPD at 0.2 seconds. In COPD, obstructive airway disease. But if you want to go, let's say, increase the T-low because we want to improve the ventilation, minute ventilation, you can also, don't go too high, 0.7 or 0.8 seconds. The next thing is, if you're having issue with oxygenation, we talked you can use, of course, FiO2 100%. And then after that, make sure oxygenation is stable. Don't touch P high until the FiO2 equal or less than 50% and AutoSat is above 92 to 95%. So that's very important. At that point, you start coming on P high 2 to 3 cm every couple of hours to 2 H2O every Q, let's say 2 to 4 hours. And while you're doing this, I encourage you go with T high, you increase T high by 1 to 1.5 seconds until we reach a point where is our patients can be looking like this. P high equal or less than 18, P low equals 0, T high equal to 9 seconds, T low 0.5 seconds roughly. Respiratory rate will be depends on the values here. At that point, with these values, plus patient is stable hemodynamically, not on vasopressors, ABG looking good, patient awake, then you may start thinking, okay, it's time to do SBT, which is spontaneous breathing trial, which I explained in my mechanical ventilations course. Whether you do a pressure support or CPAP, you can simply switch them directly from this to a pressure support mode and then continue with weaning as we explained. One last thing I want to talk about here is the pruning. When we do APRV, we really don't need, if we do it properly, we don't need to prone them. So this mode can help us avoid pruning, which is a big, another big advantage of APRV, because the logistic that pruning needs, a lot of personnel, a lot of care. So if we can avoid that, that would be great. The last advice, when you put these patients on APRV or TCAV method, make sure you monitor them and make sure, please, to give it time. Don't give it half an hour and say, oh, it's not working. The APRV or TCAV method is a recruitment method, but it's a slow recruitment method that can take up to 10 to 12 hours, if not longer, to recruit alveoli and reach stable alveoli. At that point, we start coming down on the parameters. If the patient failed to improve after that, then we start looking, is the patient a candidate for ECMO and other stuff. So that's all about using TCAV in COVID patients. Remember, you don't have to heavily sedate or paralyze them unless they are fighting the ventilator. You can avoid pruning. They can be lightly sedated, breathing comfortably with this mode, and give it time to work and monitor the patient, please.